This disabled gaming reviews Let's Play is best enjoyed in front of a computer monitor and or tablet with the speakers on. And to any epileptics out there, please watch this in a well-lit environment to reduce the risk of any potential seizures. This DGR Police Party is also unofficially sponsored by Boom and Mini Boom in Air. So Boom and Mini Boom are a geek boutique where if you're looking for things like Dragon Ball mugs, alien figurines, etc., etc., definitely check them out. Did I also mention that they're an official Warhammer retailer? So if you're looking for extra fire team squads to add to your Tau army, definitely check them out. They are located opposite Airbus Station. Look out for the Deadpool statue. Links to Boom and Mini Boom's Facebook page is in the video's description below. Now with all that aside, please enjoy the video. One of the everyone's Spartan Commander 1990, Chief Editor of Disabled Gaming Reviews here. Welcome to part 8 of my Let's Play of Max Payne for the PC. So, last time we went through the Cold Steel Steel Foundry spot, we uncovered a massive governmental conspiracy which explains the murder of Max's family in the very start of the game. When we left off, we also uncovered the identity of the person who killed Max's friend, DEA Special Agent Alex Balder. So it turned out it was BB. So we left, since we left off, Max is just tailing BB to basically to avenge him. So, and again, no Miles, because my Twintail co-pilot is still in America. So, but anyway, let's get this show on the road. Anyway, trivia question for you. The title of the last part was in Swedish. So, can you guys see if you guys can translate that? And leave your answers down in those comments. Okay, that's my timer started. Let's go. But come on, son. Don't think I can see you there. So I've got 38 minutes on frame and seconds on the clock.
Hey! Charlie.
Real charmer, ain't ya? Seeing this. So we've got 34 minutes 27 seconds on the clock.
Reports of a fire at the Punchinello Manor in Westchester. The manor is the home of Angelo Punchinello, the alleged head of the Punchinello crime family. The police are now saying, contrary to their earlier statements, that Max Payne is still alive and at large. He continues his vendetta against the Mafia, of which this last act of arson is attributed to.
I had no recollection of setting any fires, but I did remember the flames.
wherever you are.
You know, I really hate people who refuse to see me.
The payphone started to ring. Yeah.
Max Payne?
Whatever does it for you.
This is Alfred Woden. I can give you the name of your enemy. Come to the Asgard building presently. We are expecting you.
Well, that's that then. For the... for that chapter? No, here we go. So I've got 27 minutes and 10 seconds on the clock. So I'll try my best to get through this much as
possible. Woden
was
waiting for me on the steps of the old building.
Mr. Payne, let's go inside. The others are anxious to begin.
The others?
Despite the general misconception, this building actually predates the City Hall by 2 years, thus being the oldest municipal building still in use here at the foot of the Brooklyn Bridge.
No kidding. The old man played tour guide as he led me through a dark domed hall. The answers I was after loomed large ahead.
Mr. Payne, I would like to introduce you to my colleagues in what we call the Inner Circle.
You've been watching too much X-Files.
You have seen the files on Project Valhalla. We can fill the gaps, provide you with the information missing from those files. We were all involved in the early stages of the project during the Gulf War.
What's the catch?
We would very much like to blow this thing wide open, but our hands are tied. Her name is Nicole Horn. She was the key figure in Project Valhalla. When the funding was discontinued, she simply refused to quit. She knew exactly what she had in her hands. Nicole Horn is the president of Acer Corporation. She has more than half the city in her pocket. This must be kept under wraps. If you try to go public with this, we will deny any knowledge. We need you to take her out. Afterwards, we can protect you. Make all the charges go away.
That was the cue for the killer suits to kick in the doors and swarm inside. It was an impressive floor show, but I decided to leave early anyway. It was only a one-story fall. Lucky me.
One-story fall? So, coming to think of it, how high is... Coming to think of it, guys, how high is one story in meters? Answers, as always, is down in the comments.
One of the monitors showed what was left of the Inner Circle. On screen, the so-called corpse of Alfred Woden stood up, miraculously waking from his dirt nap, looking smug among his dead pals. In the land of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. I didn't know how he'd pulled it off, but it was a pretty slick way to get out of all his promises. Most of what he had said fit too well to be a load of crap.
Engaging customer.
And, I think James Dank.
Acknowledged. Target escaped. Last confirmed location, the inner courtyard. Search and destroy.
Hey, what are you saying, search and destroy? What do you think this is, Call of Duty? So I have 22 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock.
One of the monitors showed what was left of the inner circle.
Cover me. I'm going in.
Okay, so I've got 21 minutes and 30 seconds on the clock. I'm not stupid enough to fall for the same trick twice. The film for...
Whatever.
And what is your answer to those saying that he is actually providing a service long overdue to the city?
This crusade nonsense has gone too far. He's out of control. It must stop. He will be stopped.
That was Deputy Chief Jim Bravura from the New York City Police Department.
Okay, that's it. Okay, now... now it's gonna be on the... Let's grab...
A videotape layup. Woden had left me a present. Nicole Horn had blackmailed the Inner Circle into silence. The tape came with a curt extortion note on a piece of expensive paper. I remembered Candy Dawn taping her clients in action on the side, selling the tapes to the highest bidder. I was sure that kinky sex was nowhere near Alfred Woden's worst sin. But I had a feeling that when this was over, any collateral would come in handy.
That's fair.
Woden had taken care of my mission preps with military precision. The critical areas in the Acer Corporation headquarters blueprints were circled in red. The president's office was at the top of the building, right below her penthouse suite. The elevators were controlled by a security computer, part of the mainframe located underground below the building. The high rise was sealed as tight as a sci-fi fortress.
Nothing seems to stop Acer Corporation's phenomenal victory march. Incredibly, the stocks are still rocketing. Worried experts already see a danger in the company's success. Some have gone as far as to say that Acer Corporation is about to become an even bigger monopoly than Microsoft ever was.
Oh, bigger monopoly than Microsoft ever was. Common installed operating systems on PCs. You know what, guys? Another open question is in order. To all you PC gamers out there such as me, which operating... Don't interrupt me. I was saying... Tell me which operating system...
Go!
May have gone overkill, but I do not care. If it gets the job done, it gets the job done. So I'm saving this. I have 13 minutes and 10 seconds on the clock. You have just killed yourselves. How does that feel? Yeah, what that thinking, bro?
The best movie ending ever?
Yo!
Seconds on oh, good. That's that through, and this one we're now going into the Byzantine.
I dreamed of revenge. Those dreams were always nightmares, of coming close and then failing. Now I was close. I had a name to guide me, Nicole Horn. I had nothing to lose.
Max's position, I did the same.
The inner circle had quite a track record. Project Valhalla had not been the only thing the inner circle had been involved in. There were rows of cabinets full of files. The Serpentine Secret Society went back a long way, always pulling strings from the shadows. I couldn't say I was sorry. Woden's move in some Byzantine power game had cut the Circle's membership roster to one. The old man wanted me on cleanup duty. It was my mess, too.
Seconds on the clock. As you can see, it's a labyrinth.